Alright, I guess so. I guess, I don't know, I'm kind of starstruck by my own ignorance. My gosh, I've been trying, learning these words, and going through and learning these words. I'm like, well, I think I have the tones, I'm getting the tones pretty well. But then I'm like, well, I have to learn the words, you know, keep bringing the words in, you know. I only know a few songs, so I have to bring more and more into my repertoire. And yet, it's like, can you teach that, you know, the old dog new tricks, you know, keeps coming up. And I'm like, now I'm just the idiot who has to keep saying the milestone phrase again and bringing it back into this adjunct computer. And I'm sorry for that one, but I guess I'll be the one who said it. Okay, so then I said it, and I'm like, no, or you find out right away. You find out right away how many brain cells are dead, or killed, or sloughed off, or they're just no longer there. As soon as you start attacking learning lines, if you go back into learning lines again, and I'm not kidding about learning lines, like had only I stayed. I mean, dancing is... I'm beginning to think ballet dancing was just mental retardation in comparison. I'm beginning to think that as an artistic state, painting and what's that other thing? Ballet dancing, just mental retardation. I just think it's just stupidity. And as soon as you have to do this, you have got to look at the papers, and you got to look at the lines, you got to bring it into vocalizations. It's just like, whoa. It's a major whoa. Yeah, I feel really, really dumb. Really, really dumbed down. Like, and then I'm like, okay, so who can I blame? You know, well, first of all, you go back to blaming your race. You blame your negative inputs. You know, I've had, you know, you're a female, yeah, all of this. Okay, so then you have this other negative, and another negative, and another negative, and it's just become your own head speak, you know, like I'm gonna speak negative again to my own head, you know, and say, oh, I can't do that, I'm tired. Oh, I'm you know, you just have just a list of excuse after excuse after excuse of negatives. And they're not the positive affirmations at all, they're the other ones. They're like, what an idiot, you know, you should have done it by now. You know, those types of things, you know, they're just like, just rolling through my head, like, you know, I've been singing since when? You know, since, I don't know, almost 10 years, and then, yeah, okay, I had like 3 years that were really interrupted, but it's not the point that I'm older, it's not the point of any of those things, it's the point that I should have learned them all already, you see, and so that even that is a negative. That is a negative impartation that I'm giving to myself. So I'm looking at this, and I'm going through the line, going to the next line, I'm going, well, this isn't working, maybe I have to be the visual kind and put a sunshine soleil somewhere, and then put an ice melt. I put the ice melt polar bear, which was a symbol on one of these things, next to Sigello. That word, the S-G-E-L-O, which means to melt, to thaw. And so I'm like, okay, and that actually worked. So I guess it popped into my brain. So I'm one of those type. So now I'm like so mentally retarded, I have to say to myself again a negative affirmation, that because I'm trained at that trick, that if you go back to... If had only I started when I was a little child, looking at these words with pretty images, you know, then I would be able to. I've been speaking Italian. I would have been speaking the French. I would have known the arias. I would have had a career, a really major career, available to me. Instead, I'm looking at just piece parts of. Oh my gosh! I think I can sing an exaltate. At somebody's funeral, you know, it's just like, you know, now, so that's just like, forget it, you know, what do I want to sing that way for? You know? That would be a funny one at the funeral, huh? Yeah. Yay! Finally! just get it over with, you know, everybody just exulting in jubilations. And yeah, so yeah, that's all I can say is the in the aspirations. Oh my God, she's a coloratura. Well, she sings. There is just ridiculous. I have a competition with you know, myself. I have a competition, but then it's like that part of reality is mixed in with. Oh my gosh, there are so many words. And so then you have to hear. You know, you have to hear the song. You have to hear the libretti in your head. So you have to hear it, then you have to sing it at the same time, at the same speed. Remember all the words. And it's just like, so that's just a flogging. It's just a flogging event. It's almost like, what's the deal? I'm just into life abuse. It's like my favoritism for self here is life abuse. And this is it, you know. How can I abuse myself more? Sing opera, you know. Start late in life and sing opera. Anyway. Yeah, tra-la-la. And that doesn't go fast. Your tra-la-las are slow because you're old. So forget your tra-la-las fast if you're starting at my age. Just forget it. La-la-la-la. Yeah, it's like the tongue. It just becomes like, Yeah. So yeah, you find where you're mentally retarded, really extra in your brain. It's such an interesting quest. So that's what I'm doing lately, is I'm learning the words. And you know what? They're difficult. They're not all there. And so you have to get the scores. You have to buy the scores to get the exact words. And then, because they're, what do you call them? Anthologies. The anthologies are not actually always correct. They're just giving like the smattering of the words. They're not giving the repeats or the go backs or a few reversals. And so I'm finding all of this out, and that's like, oh great. So now I had to buy the score books. And so if you don't have the score books for the exact, you can go to that IMSLP, I guess it's the IMSLP or whatever, and sift through. Those are the entire operas, and they're very difficult to actually find that particular aria. So there. Anyway, I did have a great idea for money making for the opera, for opera people, and entertaining and encouraging it, because it is such a devastant. I think even if you're young starting it, it's difficult to start learning all these lines and continue. You know, it's very difficult. Right? So you look at Callas and you're looking at her and going, oh my God. You know, she's sang all of those songs. All of those. You look at all of these greats like Netrebko, and you're looking at Fleming, and you're looking at Tabaldi or Moffo. You're looking at all of those and you're going, oh my God, these women are just amazing. And Montserrat Caballé. Unbelievable. Joan Sutherland. All of them. Just incredible. And I'm just listing, you know, a lot of the old ones, you know, the older ones. And I keep getting her name wrong, Mrs. Sweetie from Switzerland. What's her name? Not the Lucia Pop one, the other one. Not the Ponselli. The other one. I love her. I love her singing, actually. Gun, come on. No, it really is. It's like this. Gundava. Is it Gundava? Come on. No, Grunova, that's it, Grunova. Okay, so I believe it's Grunova, yeah. So yeah, all of this, did I get that wrong again? This was one woman, I don't understand. Grubarova. Okay, so yes, Grubarova. Beautiful, wonderful voice, she sings the Casadiva. She sings the the very, very beautiful vise, not vise arte, yeah, that also probably, but she sings very beautiful troppo. So yeah, I'm like, what's the deal? What's the deal, you know? It's just impossible. It's sometimes, so yeah, it's just like, starting at the bottom of the hill, you know, like the vision of the life, you know, starting at the bottom of the hill, now it just feels like it, you know, it's like, I'm never gonna get there, never gonna get there. But I persist just to persist. So I guess I get better though through the years. I do find there are skills I have obtained. I can always teach music, singing. I can teach it, I suppose. So I've learned that much. But I am actually kind of worried about the person's learning opera and continuing this as a take all into the future. I don't think we have enough opera singers. I don't think we have enough stage artists that get there. You know what I'm saying? They actually get there. They actually can say, okay, no words now, you know, and they're on the stage. I don't think we have that many. So yeah, that's our drama. And then you know, keeping that that encouragement. So what did I come up with? Oh my gosh, one video I know it. The encouragement was some kind of radio show. We can get a radio show of the young singers. It can be singers from around the world, and then just in their training, their daily training, and all their mess ups. And so it'd be very interesting. You know, you get them after, you know, they've been training a good 5 years, so they're good enough, and yet they're not great. They're just in the middle, and so it's kind of like a help, encouragement, boost. You know, stay. You know, because we need them on the stage. You know, we need them on the stage. We don't need them to back out and say, "Oh my gosh, it's just too difficult." You know, it's just too time worthy of my life. I can't make it. I can't do it. So this will be a little extra impetus, and maybe, you know, pass some money out to them somehow. But yeah, so that's just an idea to keep the opera alive and healthy, because we don't fit in any of those idol show type of things. But it would be absolutely fun, and it doesn't have to be live. It would be like recorded. You know, the different sessions of the artists recorded, and then put them together, you know, like, so you have a day, and then the next day, and the next day, and the next day, but then you just, you know, maybe a week from then, you know, so they're aired later, the groupings. And so you'd have somebody recording this, and then putting the different artists together, and so you would have, like, you know, your 8 to 12 hour time frames that just keep going. So in a way it would be live, it would be a live action, and so you can actually have your patrons of the arts follow your career, even from when you're 5 years in to your singing, when you're 8 years into your singing. So it'd be quite an interesting show, actually. Something else, you know, and it's also bringing live back to radio, which would be something. Because I believe radio is just kind of a deadpan situation of reruns, a rerun and rerun. And these would be live events. So going, oh my gosh, no, her cast of divas is terrible today. Oh my gosh! And so, but in a way, it's fun. It's funner because sometimes I'm absolutely theoretically bored of the great ones. They're just almost too perfect. You know what I mean? So I kind of like the flaws. When they're upset, all of a sudden it's just like refreshing in a way, because then it also does. It teaches the audience to appreciate better musicality, teaches the audience also. So all of these are things that progress us as a civilization. You know, if we shy away from these types of things, and we disdain from them, and we're just like, okay, just pop culture, and just that rerun again and again and again. We heard Mariah Carey's squeal, we want to hear it again and again and again, and that's it. And then we hear whatever, you know, somebody else, Aguilera or something, you know, a rerun of her again and again. And so I'm like, well, no, I would prefer live and fresh. I think that would be kind of fun. So maybe that would bring radio into something more interesting. And yeah, and then you just process that through with commercialization of, what do we call them? I guess commercial people, advertisements run it. And then they would somehow pay the artists that are participating and their helper, recorder persons, you know, whoever they are. So yeah, that will be kind of an interesting help, I think so.